Welcome to another Bleistift video, and today I want to have a quick look at the Kaweco Student fountain pen, and this is the 70s Seoul edition. Very unusual look. I mean, to me this looks even older than the 70s, color scheme wise. Nice kind of beige here, kind of beigey, slightly grey orange here, gold trim, and mine here is with an EF nib. And I have a few Kaweco fountain pens with EF nibs, but this is by far the finest and the smoothest EF nib. Let's have a quick look. Here's some French made Lyreco paper. So this is the 70 Seoul. Just to put it into perspective, here's a Platinum Preppy. It's 0.3 millimeter, I guess that's what it's supposed to mean. Now the fault here is partly with the French Lyreco paper. It makes the lines a bit wider than some other papers would do. Yeah, but you can see here the 70 Seoul has a much finer line than the Preppy O3, which is already, you know, pretty fine to start with. Let's go even finer. As a comparison, here's the Preppy in O3 in red, and here we got the Preppy in O2. This is I think the latest edition. I think these are a bit older. This is kind of one of the finest fountain pens I have. I have a Falcon, which is extremely fine, but a very flexible nib SEF. So there's a lot of variation. But here's the Preppy in 0.2, and that's a bit finer, yeah, or not a bit finer, that's certainly finer, certainly on this paper. But yeah, the 70 Seoul, very fine nib, extremely smooth. Let's use the Post-it as a comparison. And now the 0.2. Yeah. So very fine, but the, you know, the 0.2 Preppy, quite scratchy. You might have heard it. The Kaweco, very fine. I asked them about it. I was wondering, did Kaweco actually change the way they make nibs? Or yeah, they buy the nibs in, but did they change something? And the answer I got was something along the lines of the fine nibs are very popular in East Asia, yeah, because of the Chinese characters, or, you know, kanjis in Japanese. So I think the answer I got gave me the impression that actually the way they do the nib is not actively different than it used to be. But either, you know, over the time this got better, or maybe this EF nib is a bit, you know, is just a very good nib that came off the belt. Yeah. But it's very nicely made, and you can see here, you know, this is a nice effect, how the reflection changes. Yeah, the color scheme might not be everybody's cup of tea. Yeah, here's a golden metal grip section, but it is certainly a very nice fountain pen if you like this style of color, and it certainly is an excellent writer. Okay. Thank you very much for watching and goodbye.